Hey, this is Papa from Street Fighter Trading System.com. Alright guys, so this will be a series of, I guess, 5 videos which will be related to the Papa Challenge. So recently we finished the bootcamp. I showed you how what makes basically a good fail to legged pullback. But the idea is that we were always reviewing the chart and not playing live, right? So the idea now is to understand how can we, while playing live, of course still on sim, take only good trades. And you will see it's very, very difficult, right? So for that, I created a challenge. So I repeat the rules. The initial amount was 25K on sim. The goal is to have in 5 days $200 profit. And you should not draw down your account below $24,450. So you must not lose more than $550, okay? You need to trade at least 3 days. And the person who will win, they will have the possibility to win my indicator that can show every single setup on the screen. So Pikachu, high or low, two-legged pullback, and so on, even while the setup is happening live. As you see here, for example, here it's saying that it's the pivot one, even though this bar hasn't closed yet, okay? So, the first day happens, so what I'm gonna do is that I will probably not have the time to participate for all the days, but I will show you an example of the first day that happened because I participated. And I'm going to show you how you should post your trades and how it's going to work, right? So the idea is you go in the market, you take your trades, and the goal is to reach $200 profit within 5 days, right? And it's to repeat it over and over again for several weeks until you are able to be consistently winning, okay? So this exercise, by the way, is very, very difficult because going from reviewing a chart to try to understand the chart while the setup are happening live, it's very, very tough. So I don't think that many people will succeed to reach the $200 profit, right? I'm actually quite surprised because when I was looking at the result, I see that almost everyone is positive on the first day. By positive, even $12, it's good, right? I saw that Alberto is negative, but it's all right, as I said. So you can still come back to a positive level, but this exercise is very, very difficult, right? And this bootcamp only lasted a month. So I will be very surprised, to be honest with you, if I see 90% of the people succeeding the challenge. My expectation is that there is maybe one or two people only that will succeed, but let's see. Maybe what I've taught you during the bootcamp is so exceptional that everyone will be positive at the end. Anyway, so let me talk about the trades that I've taken as of yesterday, right? Because I also want to show you what I usually do when I trade, because I think I haven't really spoke about it, but my main concern is always the short-term trend line. And during the bootcamp, I haven't really emphasized on it, but I will show you how I use it on all my trades, okay? So the day begin at 8:30 Thai time, okay, 8:30 p.m. So yesterday was a very, very tough day because the price was basically on a constant consolidation, okay? So when it started, we were on a consolidation, so I see no setup. The first setup that I saw happened actually at this time, so at 9:15. And what I saw is basically that we were again in a range. After an impulsive move, we were again doing a range, okay? So since it's the first impulse, okay, but I'm looking to see if I can find another setup to go long, okay? So the thing is, when you are in a range, to go long, you need to be able to buy from the bottom of the range, okay? So I was checking, so as I don't take two-legged pullback, I cannot take this two-legged pullback, so the first setup happened with this Pikachu over here. Okay, so what I do when I see this is first I draw, okay, so I will draw a range where the price is closing. So for example, this candle closed at the same level as this candle closed at the same level, so I start drawing a horizontal line like this, okay? Here also, I have two candles that close at the same price, so I draw an horizontal line. So here what happened is I saw this Pikachu, Okay. So, this Pikachu, when I saw it, the first thing that I check when I have a Pikachu is to check if I have an opposing short-term trend line. Okay, because what is the main problem of a Pikachu when it doesn't work is because it's the main pain point of a two-legged pullback, and the main pain point is if you have an opposing short-term trend line. Okay, so I draw my opposing short-term trend line and I don't see anything that is opposing, meaning that this entry candle, this blue line over here, it doesn't oppose. Okay, I am at the bottom of the range. And there was kind of a breakout over here, like a failed breakout, I will say. Okay, I am at the bottom. I have a candlestick, which is a hammer type of candlestick. So, what I did is that I placed a buy stop over here. So, maybe let me activate my. So entry over here. So, I don't know why it entered over here and not over here. But anyway, so I entered over here at 32.85, so I placed a buy stop above this candle, and then I have the ATM strategy that basically goes for 1 point. But what happened, the reason why I didn't get 1 point out of this is the price did 1 point and then came back to my 50, okay, for my 2 ticks profit, okay, it didn't did 5 ticks, that's why the price came back down, okay. So this is the first step that I've taken. Again, it's a Pikachu that happens on the bottom of a range. I saw that I had space of 1 point between my top and my bottom. I have a good candlestick pattern and I don't have opposing short-term trend line. Okay. The next trade came a little bit later. So it's the Raichu. So again, why did I enter this trade? So I saw again over here. What make me enter is from this, I saw the price goes down, and then same situation for me. This is like a failed breakout that happens on the bottom of the range. Okay, but this I didn't know it was the bottom before I saw this. So for me, first this is the range, but after I understood that this was the middle of the range, okay, and not the top of the range. So what I do is I always draw horizontal line when I see the price closing at the same level. So this candle close at the same level of this one, at the same level of this, and at the same level of this, right? So I'll draw an horizontal line, and what I was waiting for is to have a failed two-legged pullback that happens within the range. Other stuff that I look at is people that wants to take two-legged pullback, okay, when there is a short-term trend line that is opposing. And if you draw it over here, so I know that people, what they will try to do is that they will try to take the two-legged pullback over here. Right? Why? Because this is a good candlestick. It's a bearish candlestick. It's a two-legged pullback. But you see here, the short-term trend line is acting as opposition. Okay, and it's a Pika at the same time. And what did I say? If I have a Pikachu, okay, with opposing short-term trend line, most of the time it's gonna fail. Okay, so when I see this, actually I haven't saw the Raichu, but what I saw is this. Okay. I had this on my screen and I saw that I had this. So, what I was waiting for is simply to have this thing fail and place a buy stop over here, right? So, it happened that my chart showed that it's at the same time a Raichu, meaning that it's a failed two-legged pullback and a higher low at the same time. So, it again gives me another layer of confidence that this trade was going to work. And we saw it. It when basically, when I put a buy stop, it directly shoots up. Right, because here we are sure that people were trapped over here. This is sure, right? When this thing happened and you have a candle that shoot up directly like this, it means that people has been trapped because they are not respecting the short-term trend line. Okay. Other trade that I taken. So I point out other interesting trade. So this one is also an interesting trade that I haven't taken live. Okay. So. Again, the idea is when you have a setup is to check if you have an opposing short-term trend line, and you have it over here, right? So this is your short-term trend line. So meaning that probably some people, what they're looking at is to take the two-legged pullback over here, right? But here, as I say, if you have the opposing short-term trend line that act as opposition, you should never try to short. Okay, never try to take a two-legged pullback where you have an opposing short-term trend line. And again, it's what happened. It went down, People place a buy stop over here and the price shoot up. Okay. Well, the reason why I haven't taken this trade is because I think it's fairly dangerous to take a counter trend trade on a second impulse. So it's the first one, second one. Okay. I usually take reversals only after four. Okay. But the situation is that it's a setup which is, as I said, with the short term trend line opposition. So this is kind of my signature move. So back in the days, I would have taken this thing maybe 100 times. Okay, so all right. Something happened over here. I don't think that this is a good setup, to be honest. The candlestick is not good. And here, the setup is basically outside bar, meaning that you had to anticipate on this candle. Now, one thing is, as you know, I haven't deep dive inside outside bar, but one thing that made outside bar good is if the candlestick is, this candlestick is good because people, if they see an inverted hammer, but what they will do, they will try to short because they think it's a good hammer, right? So anticipating the trade over here, I think it's a good trade for outside bar. But again, I don't take outside bar, so I haven't taken this setup. The next one that I've taken, that I haven't taken, is this TTT. I think it was a fairly good TTT. So here you see the price close over here at the same level. We have a failed two-legged pullback over here. So it failed. So the two-legged pullback failed. The failed two-legged pullback failed. So the idea is to place a buy stop over here. So I place it with a triangle. I saw that Suzu on Facebook has taken it. I think it's a good trade because the context over here is that you are buying at the bottom of the range. Okay, even though it's a bad candlestick, it's still okay to take that. Now, I personally wouldn't take that because the only TTT that I take, as I said, is a TTT which is a Pikachu. Okay, so this, for example, this is actually a TTT, right? It's kind of a TTT because we have like a two-legged pullback. Then we have the Pika that failed, and then you buy over here, right? So this is the situation of TTT that I usually buy, meaning that I have a Pika that failed, and then I have a failed two-legged pullback that happened on the opposite side, okay? But this is also a type of setup that also work, meaning that you take a TTT when you are at the bottom of the range or at the top of the range, okay? Last trade that I've taken, so not going to talk about this Raichu. It's actually this. So I saw an ABC type of retest. So I saw the impulse, I saw the ABC. So when I see this ABC, the thing that I will do, I will measure this move, okay? And then I will report it over here. So for me, the target is now to find a long, okay? A long opportunity because I have impulse, ABC. Then the idea is to find either a failed two-legged pullback or whatever that can shoot to the target. Okay, it happened that the target was not met, by the way. You can see that over here, the target was at 3,302, but it only reached 3,295.50. Okay, but it's fine. The idea is just the measure move should just help you to show you which direction you should play. Okay. So the idea for me was to find a setup that will be at the bottom of the range again that I can take, and it happened over here. Okay, so again, first thing that I try to do, I try to draw what I call the short-term trend line. Okay, so this will be this, so the opposing short-term trend line. I don't know how you call it, but as I said to you, what I try to take a look at is people that are trying to short. Okay. Because they're taking two-legged pullback but not respecting this short-term trend line over here, okay? So it's the case, they didn't respect it, I put a buy stop over here. And then what happened is that, I think that on my trading logs, so I got 1 point from this. And then what happened is the price went down again. So as you know, and as I showed you on my bootcamp, when I reach $100 gain, I will change my ATM strategy to be this one, meaning to be 4 points, so 1 point stop loss, okay? So I will tighten up my stop loss, and I will have infinite profit, okay? Like that, if I lose, I will only lose $50. So if I lose on the day, I win 100, I lose 50. So at the end of the day, I'm up $50. Okay, so this is how I usually understand where I need to stop or if I need to continue. So I did it, and unfortunately, so it went up and I got stopped out over a year. Okay, so this is basically what happened. I can show you my trading performance. So trade performance for yesterday. So trade. So it was which day? So the third. Okay, boom. Okay, so we can see over here how I entered. So by the way, the strategy that I'm using is the DIN strategy, meaning over here. Okay, so it's basically it's close to what I've given to you guys, but the only thing that changed is this thing, meaning that the second step is to put, if it reach 5 ticks, then it will go, the stop loss will automatically go 1 tick below. Okay, I had some people asking me what is this frequency stop. Okay, so maybe I'll clarify it on this video. So the first two frequency, you don't need to take care of it. It can be arbitrary. It can be 5, it can be 10 if you want to. Okay, this doesn't matter, right? But the so stop modified, okay. What matters is the last one. What it means is that every single time that the price is gonna do, so let's say it reached 2 points, so 8 ticks profit, the stop loss is gonna go 3 ticks below the 8 ticks. Okay, but every time the price is gonna move up 3 ticks again, so frequency is every single time the price move up 3 ticks profit, the stop loss is gonna follow by 3 ticks below. Okay, so this is what it means. The frequency means that every time that you have n tick profit, okay, so on this thing 3 ticks profit, then the price is gonna follow, for the stop loss is gonna follow up to 3 ticks. Okay. So this is pretty much the trade I've taken. I showed you my performance and so on. So as I said, it was a very difficult day to start the challenge, but that's the reality of trading, my friends. Trading is extremely difficult. Okay, so that's why you will probably not get a Lambo after 3 days or 2 days. It will take you probably years to become consistent because this market is really, really, really tough. Okay, but the idea is this: is the whole idea of this challenge is to show you first that trading is very difficult, even though I've given you a lot of tips and tricks. You still need on your side to work on showing and looking and understanding the setup when they happen live. Okay. Number two, it also give a purpose to the sim, because one problem that I think is people, they once they're on sim, they take every single fucking trade. Okay, but it cannot work like this. You cannot be consistent if you take all the trades in the world. Okay, what you need is to select your trade, and this, by doing this challenge, so this is a 1 week challenge, but you should actually challenge yourself multiple weeks so that you can build trust on yourself, on understanding the market where it is live. Okay, so that's why I encourage everyone to do it. Never mind if you lose and you don't win it, the important is to participate, as many people say. Okay. And the more you will do it, the more you will become confident, and also it will work on your psychology, right? Because another thing that I want you to also learn during this challenge is how to learn to know how to stop trading on a specific day. Okay, because let's say today the drawdown is 550. If you keep trading and taking all the trades and you keep losing, you are not managing your money correctly, right? So you need to know when to stop, probably after one loss or two loss, and then come to the next day, okay? And have a fresh day, have a fresh start. Also, if you made some mistake, just log your trades and try to understand why, okay? Why did it fail? If it works, you also need to understand why. So for example, me, I explain you why I took the trade. You need to understand why you took it. If it failed, why did it fail? So that you can improve from day to day. Okay, so this is it for the video of today. I'm not sure that I will have the time to play live today, but I wish good luck to all the participants, and I'll see you next time. This was Papa from StreetFighterTradingSystem.com.